graph. The question in our books is not really simple, so fine intercepts, but I want to solve the problem completely. So in order to graph, first of all, we need to know where the function exists, the domain of the function. This is a polynomial function. As you can see, we can use any real number in x. The domain is from minus infinity to plus infinity. So it exists everywhere, all real numbers. Now let's check general characteristics of the function. This is 4-degree function, even function. Leading coefficient 1, positive. So obviously, this function opens up in both sides, on the left, on the right. Correct? Now, how many possible solutions? So maximum number of solutions. N, which is 4, correct? So the shape of our function should be, if open up here and here, in order to have 4 solutions, only by this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, could be 2 if the axis goes here, could be 2 if the axis goes here, or no solutions, no interceptions if the axis goes down. How many number of turning points? N minus 1, which is 3.
Yes,
3 turning points. They are located by this way. So this is the general shape. In order to graph exactly, we need to calculate some points. The easier method will be using x and y intercepts. Can I continue here? So let's check y intercept. Y intercept exists when x equals to 0. So if I make x equals to 0, 0, 0, y will be 1. So the first intercept is located in 0,1. 0,1, right here. Now let's check where are located x intercepts. They exist when y equals to 0. So make the function equals to 0. X to the 4th power minus 2 x squared plus 1 equals to 0. As you can see, it resembles a perfect square trinomial. X minus 1 squared. Are you agree with me? Bravo. So what we have here is x minus 1 times x plus 1. This is a difference of a square. Square, 2 times, so one more time, x minus 1 times x plus 1. Equals to 0. We have 4 solutions, as we predicted before. X equals to 1, x equals to minus 1, x equals to 1, x equals to minus 1. But 2 of them are the same. The other 2 also are the same. resulting that we have only two solutions. But I want to use this example to explain one more property, multiplicity. What is multiplicity? Let's check. Can I continue here? Multiplicity. That equation can be written if considering that 2 times x minus 1, x minus 1 squared times x plus 1 squared equals to 0. It's exactly the same equation, different arrangement. What we have here is x minus 1 and x minus 1, because this solution is repeated 2 times. The multiplicity is even 2 times. The other one also is repeated 2 times. It's the same solution 2 times. The multiplicity is 2, because 2 times. It's the same solution. We don't need to write it 2 times. We don't need to do this operation. Directly from previously, we know that we have 2 times the same solution. The multiplicity is even number, 2 times. The same situation if we have 4 times, 6 times. What we can get from that property? Very interesting. Can I continue here? Very interesting. If the multiplicity is even number, the function never crosses the axis x. The function reflects by this way or by this way. If the multiplicity is odd number, so the same solution 1 time or 3 times or 5 times, in this case, the function crosses the axis x. So now we can graph this question very fast. We know the intersections are in plus 1 and in minus 1. Here, minus 1, here, plus 1. We know that this function opens up on the left, on the right. The only intercept, 3 turning points. Only 2 solutions, only 2 interceptions. The only possible path is that one. If I want perfect graph, I can verify using the value of the function in 0.5, for example, in 2, f in 2, etc., etc. I can test 2, 3, 4 points in order to get exact picture. But I believe that you can solve this problem maximum in 40, 60 seconds. I believe that from now you can graph faster than if using graphic calculator, using what you are learning from today.